Today I have Brianna. I brought her in as a special part of the class that we're teaching here. And Brianna is a student of mine, and she has just finished shooting 6 days on a TV show. And the reason I've got her here is to be able to talk to you about some of the realities. In all of my classes, I'm always telling you about this stuff, and it can get a little boring. But for somebody who has just done it, you need to hear it, and I want you to get inspired by it. That's why I brought her here, to be able to go through this. Okay? So can you give her a big hand for a moment, please? And just a little bit here, just a little bit. I met Brianna about a year and a half ago.
Yeah, it'll be 2 years this March.
2 years this March, wow, time flies. And she had braces on, and she was thinking about acting, and she wasn't sure. So I laid a plan out for her. I met her in one of my camps up in Newmarket. And then we laid a plan out for her to be able to, for the year that she had her braces on, we were going to get her to be able to do lots of acting, as in learning how to audition, learning to do TV commercials, learning how to do scene study, learning how to do monologues, how to break down a scene, how to find the nuances, how to be able to play it subtly for the camera. Essentially, it was making her very aware of camera and making her very real. And throughout this whole year, her mom was really amazing and consistently put Brianna into all of these classes. Then when the braces came off, we saw about getting her an agent, got her a very big agent, and then from there she went out to doing auditions, and in a matter of a couple of months, bam, she landed a role. So what was the series called?
A Paranormal Witness.
So Paranormal Witness. This is what, the third season?
Yeah, third season, fourth episode.
Third season, fourth episode. Since you got it, I've been looking at some of the online about the show. It's amazing. It's really well received. It's an exciting show, and it's called Paranormal Witness, and it can get pretty intense.
Yeah.
So this girl gets the role, and now we're going to show them some slides in a moment, but right here, just while I have the camera rolling, because the camera is your audience as well. So tell us what it was like for you.
Okay, so before I went to the audition, and the audition was mostly improvisation, so I didn't have to learn any lines. I just went in, and they gave me a scenario callback, because it was the first callback I ever got. So I went to the callback, and I didn't feel that good about the callback, and I was kind of putting myself down about it, because I thought I could do better.
Okay, now hold on a minute. When you were putting yourself down, what were you doing?
Well, I was going, like, I really wanted the role, and I was, like, kind of, I was picking at my brain about it. I kept thinking about it and thinking about things I could have done, like, better.
Were you actually saying anything negative to you?
Yeah.
Like, what were some of the words that you were saying to yourself?
Like, you kind of chickened out, you could have done more than
you
that.
You chickened out?
Yeah.
You chickened out, you could have done more than that? What else?
You could do better than that, that wasn't your full potential.
You could do better than that? Any other real juicy negative things you were saying about yourself?
Not really, I was kind of just really upset with myself.
Upset with myself?
Yeah.
Wow, okay, so what's it like feeling upset with yourself?
It's not a good feeling because you can't like, get into that mindset and put yourself down about it. You have to just believe in what you did, think that you did the best that you could have, and just move on.
So, don't get into the mindset. This is really important. I'm doing a book on all this stuff right now. Don't get into the mindset. Focus on believing in yourself.
Because what you might not have liked, they might have liked.
There it is. What you might not have liked, they might have liked. So don't go in there into the audition and be judging yourself as you're doing the performance. Don't be judging yourself. Oh my God, as you're doing it, you're saying, oh my God, I can't believe that's terrible, that's terrible. Don't destroy your performance in front of them. Okay, it's really important you do that. Let it free, let it be out, and don't be judging it and chopping it up. Okay, what else?
That was basically it, and then my dad kept asking how I did and if I think I got it. I told him I didn't think I got it, and
right.
I didn't think I did well, but they ended up saying that they were putting me on hold,
right.
And they had to just see if I matched the rest of the family,
right.
And they had to pick the mom first.
And there's nothing you can do about that.
Yeah.
They might love her, but if she doesn't fit in and match with the rest of the family, then they're not going to take her. So there's only so much you can do, but at the end of the day, if there's her and the brother and the mom and the dad, they've all got to look like like DNA family, okay? And if you don't look like that, you can't do anything about it. It's got nothing to do with your talent. All right, so go ahead, keep going.
So I was just really excited that I was wrong and what I didn't like, they liked. And so I was happy and I was just really excited that even if I was on hold, even if I didn't get it, I was just really proud that I was their number one pick and everything. So they ended up saying that I got it and then they wanted me to come to a rehearsal. So they said to come to the rehearsal and they were gonna take photos of us as a family. So when they had to shoot it, there's photos of us in the house because it has to look like we actually live there. And then they did a dress rehearsal to try on some clothes and figure out what looked good. So I went to that after school, and that was really fun.
And you got to keep some of the clothes, too.
Yeah, but that was after after we shot everything. And so, yeah, and then I started filming on a Tuesday. And then it was 12 hours a day, and I did 6 days.
So it was 12 hours a day. What time are you getting up in the mornings?
I usually woke up around 6 or 7.
Okay, and then you put in a full 12-hour day.
Yeah.
All right. And when you were going home, you felt what?
I felt really tired. I was happy with what I was doing because they kept telling me how good I was doing. And I felt proud of myself to be on real film set and that everything I worked towards is finally coming true. But it was really exhausting. I usually just fell asleep in the car.
Okay, so what's it like being on a real film set?
It's really exciting. I noticed as I went along, my energy kind of started dropping because it's more days, more hours. But in the beginning, I was really hyper, really excited. I just wanted to get in there and do everything.
Now, this is a great point. You got to learn to pace yourself. And I've brought this up in many classes over the years. You start out because you're all excited, and after lunch, your energy depletes,
yeah.
And now when you're getting into close-ups, your energy is gone. So you've got to learn to pace yourself. Leave yourself with enough energy to get done what you need to get done at the end of the day. All right? So it's really important. And by the fifth or sixth day, you would have learned to pace yourself, right?
Yeah.
Okay, that's really good. That's really important. What else?
So the adrenaline was kind of just there, and I was really excited. And by the sixth day, I was a lot more tired, and I couldn't wait to sleep and just when it was done. But I still didn't want it to be over because I would miss everything and then have to go back to school. And yeah, it was really upsetting the last day. I didn't want to go home, but it was fun. And they had a tutor there for me every day.
So what does the tutor do?
The tutor, I brought homework from school, and she just went over everything, and I just have to sit there doing homework, and you have to be with her at least 2 hours a day. But I'd usually do more because when I'm just waiting around, they just put me in tutoring.
Okay.
And so, yeah, she was really nice, and she taught me how to, do a lot of art stuff. And, yeah.
Now, so, just without giving any details of the scene, how many takes, what was the amount of takes, the longest amount of takes you had to do?
It was the last scene that we did, and we probably did around 15, 20 takes.
15, 20 takes.
Yeah, because they did a lot on each people's profiles,
right,
and different angles, all that.
Okay, and each time they did that, did you have to keep bringing up your energy all over again? Are you listening to this?
Calm down, and then I have to do it again.
Again, and again, and again, 15 to 20 times. So how exhausting was that?
It was really tiring, but they said when they weren't on a close-up, I could tone it down a bit just so
right.
I had my energy when I needed close-ups.
Right.
So that was good, but it was really tiring to have to cry and be that upset all over again.
So how hard was it to be crying?
It was really hard to get into that.
And then I'd cry again for take two.
Yeah.
And then cry again for take three. And then cry again for take four. And then cry again for take five. So how were you able to do that?
When I wasn't in close-ups, I wouldn't cry, but I'd just be in there.
Right.
And then when it was close-ups, they also had this tear stick thing, just if I needed help.
Okay.
So it was this thing, and it froze your eye, and it just made you cry on your own. You didn't have to do anything, it made tears come out, but you also have to try and get in there, because it's not just your eyes when you cry, your nose has to be all red, and your face has to be...
Remember I told you that when they sometimes, when they want to see you crying, they want to see things like your nose getting red, and those natural reactions? Right? So it's real. They need to get as much real as possible.
Yeah.
So the audience will believe it.
So the tear stuff is just there if you need help bringing it out.
Were you reaching into your emotion?
Yeah.
Okay. So why were they so happy with you?
They said that I was...
I need you to listen, please, because this is where you've got to go with this.
They couldn't believe that it was my first job, and they said that most people, especially on my first job, and especially kids, they're always aware that the camera's there, and it's hard not to look at it, but they said that I was really unaware of the camera, and I was just doing my thing.
So, look at these guys here in TV land, and this is what you need to realize, that the vast majority of kids go in and they're aware of the camera, and they're aware of the boom, and they're aware of the fact that they're doing all of the acting. And what's the secret here? Why were they so impressed?
Because I wasn't aware of the camera, and I was just doing what I was doing.
Because she wasn't aware of the camera, she was just doing what she was doing. And to them, because it was her first job, they felt like she had done this again and again, and she looked like a professional. And that's what they found so impressive. What else did they tell you that they liked about you so much?
They said that I looked really good on camera and I was really natural.
Well, that's, yeah, she does. She looks pretty good. She's okay. And what else?
They said that I take direction really well and they don't...
Freeze. I take direction really well. Look, they could love you, but if you don't take direction really well, the director doesn't want to work with you. So you've got to be able to be of a professional mindset and to where the director will be happy with the fact that you will take direction, okay? So the director liked the fact you take direction. What else?
He said that I'm really natural on camera. I'm not nervous at all, and I'm kind of just doing what I'm doing and having fun with it.
I'm not nervous at all. That is huge. Most people, as we've seen it, I've seen it for 20 years, and you feel it in your classes when you're going in and going up in front of the camera, nerves kick in. They want people who don't have that nervous energy, okay? They don't want you to be nervous. All right, so what else? That was good. What else did they like about you?
Yeah, that's really easy to work with. That was really fun. It was good that I was having fun with it, and I wasn't just being like, I have to do this, but I was focusing, but also just having fun and being myself.
All right, which is a winning combination. You have to focus and give them what they need. But rather than going, okay, right, let's do another take. Okay, fine. Take 14. Okay, great. Take 14. Can you believe this guy? Like, he thinks he's making up. He thinks he's Spielberg. Okay, we're going to do take 14. Instead of giving the attitude, because we're all tired, we've all been up,
she is excited.
Yeah. And people want to work with people they like, that they're excited by, that they're inspired by. That's what you need to focus on. Mr. Aaron, what did I just say?
Focused and
you have
to be inspired.
Yeah, that's what I need you to be. It's really important. Okay, what else?
Yeah.
So, these kids out here, what advice, when they're going to go to the set for the first time, what advice would you give them?
Everybody there is always really nice and they're excited to get working, so you can't be nervous or upset. Like, don't be scared of them because they're not going to bite you, and they're just there to work and they want to have fun too. So don't be nervous. Be yourself. Don't try to act like something you're not. Just have fun with it. Don't be too like, I have to do this. And don't be too serious and don't be upset to do more takes, because the more takes, the better. The more chances you have to be better and go further to your potential. And it's really fun. So just have fun with it.
Okay, beautiful. Also too, because a lot of the kids watching aren't even in Canada. So you need to get training. You need to get training. Could you imagine if you'd have stepped into the set without the training, how do you think that would have felt? What do you think would have happened?
Disastrous.
Why would it have been disastrous?
Because I probably would have been staring at the camera. I wouldn't know what a mark was. I wouldn't know what they were doing with all this stuff. And I wouldn't know what I was doing. I just, when they told me something and I wouldn't understand what they were saying, I wouldn't like know what all the terms meant.
And that would have made you even more nervous and stressed.
I would have been really uncomfortable, really nervous. I'd be really scared of the camera. I wouldn't want to do 1,000 takes. I wouldn't expect that. So I'd expect to do one and get it over with. I wouldn't expect it to be that long.
All right. Yeah. So here's the thing. wherever you are watching this video, the first thing you need to do is really get trained. Get some serious training. Get to know how to read a script, how to break down a scene, how to audition for camera, how to do improvisation. I've told you kids a thousand times, we always start with improvisation. And what was her scene? The audition? They wanted you to do improv.
And also a few of the scenes, they just said, just go with it, do whatever comes naturally, just improvise it. A lot of the scenes they wanted improvised.
Because they want to see how creative you are, they want to see what you can bring to it. When they say, oh, go ahead, just improvise, show us what you've got, and you stand there with, I can't create anything. Do you honestly think you're going to get something? No. That's why I throw you in again and again and again into improvisation. So you get used to it, right? It's a massively important tool. So for you guys at home, improvise with your friends. Get real training. Look in the phone book, look on the internet, get some real training. I even have, what's my show called? I did a show called The Actor's Success in the Making. It's like 8 hours of some very serious training and educational information that will bring you really aware. I did it with three other professionals. So you can go on my website and look up The Actor's Success in the Making, and you can take a look at that. That's going to bring you to a level, a professional level, that you're going to need to be at. Okay, so at least we've got that to go with. So take action, get some training. What else? What questions do you have for her? Any questions at all? No questions. Are you people kidding me? I have a question. Did you have a trailer or anything?
It was filmed in a real house, right. And they just had everything there. And then across the street, you got in a car, and it would drive you back and forth from set, and it was called Base Camp.
Right.
So at Base Camp was all the makeup people on the stage doing your makeup, hair, everything. And then they had the kitchen there where you ate, and so everything was just there.
Okay, we've got questions. Okay, Tatiana?
What was the story about?
I'm not really about
that. Oh, you can't talk the story? Next question?
Was it hard for you to work with the people?
No, they were all really nice, and the actors that I'm working with, they also had a lot of experience, and they helped me a lot because they really got into it, and they were just really good.
All right, yeah.
Did they have, like, I see in some movies that they, like, in some movies they're doing other movies, and they go to this place in Los Angeles.
Can't talk about that. That's going to be, like, story stuff, yeah.
Did it help you, like, in the training, when we like work like with the scene study and like how to break down like your lines, like get like to the point, did that like help you when you actually got like the scenes like from the show?
Great question.
For sure, it was. I like to use like all the tips that Chris taught me and stuff because it really helps you know the character and to get in there and understand what the story's about. So it's really important to do that.
I see. It's not about learning the lines. It's about learning the process to know how to break it down and get the little nuggets that you pull out that become part of your character. That's why you need to get training, folks. A lot of parents, they want to get their kids into the movies. I had a lady just last week phone me, and she said, oh, saw your website, love the website. I want to talk to you about getting my two kids into TV commercials. And I said, okay, well then, do they have any training? She said, well, no. I said, well, you need to get them trained. And she said, no, but you don't understand. They're natural. I said, you don't understand. They need to know what they're doing. She didn't want to hear that. I said, listen, you don't have to send your children to me. Send them to anybody, but get them trained professionally. She doesn't want to hear that because that's going to cost her money. But she wants to get them into the TV show so she can make money. What would you say to the moms out there that want to get their kids into the industry but don't want to spend money on classes?
You can't do that. You have to know what you're doing, because if you get on set and you don't know what you're doing and you're just completely like, oh, what do I do, and asking questions, they're going to fire you. They don't want that. They want someone that knows what they're doing, that's going to get the job done and is going to have fun with it and understand it. So you can't just expect to go there and know what you're doing, because it's never going to be what you expect. And if you have training, then you're going to know, and it's going to be a lot better, and you're not going to embarrass yourself.
That's a great line. It's never going to be what you expect. Now you've been on it set for 6 days. Did you learn a ton more stuff?
Yeah.
Yeah?
Yeah.
That you can see why you need to go and get training.
Yeah.
So this is the reality, okay? If you want these people to pick you for real, get training, get focused, get dedicated, be consistent in what you're doing. Even if you're in Germany, I'm talking about coming to me, get training. That's what you need. And be consistent with it. And the more you are, the more chances you step in, the more comfortable you become, and the more they say, wow, you know, she looks like the part, let's give it to her. And then you turn up on set, and she's not freaking out because she understands it. Yeah, she's still got stuff to learn, but she's got enough to go in there for them to turn around and say to her, how impressed were they by you?
They were really impressed. They couldn't believe it was my first job.
They couldn't believe it was my first job. Which means they're going to hire her again and again and again and again. At the end of the day, folks, this is about results. And if you give them great results, excellent work, it's going to come back at you. If you give them crappy results, they don't ever want to see you again.
Cool.
So now you know it's real. Because this didn't happen by accident. And this is really important for you at home to get this as well. This didn't happen by accident. We were working on this for, well, almost 2 years. We've been building her by design. Success doesn't happen by accident. It happens by design. So now I'm going to have a web page dedicated to her. She's going to have more stuff going on there. You'll be able to go to my site, sentv.tv, click on, you'll see Brianna on the main page, click, and you'll get her page. We're building her as a brand because the girl is going places. And it's about building you as a brand. You don't just go and do a job and forget it. You've got to start thinking. You have your Facebook page, right? But you're now going to develop your...
Yes.
Professional Facebook page, and she's getting the website through me. The website is going to be going on. So you've got to build, Brianna's got to build who Brianna is as a brand. That's where you need to go. Okay? So when they see her, they know what she can do, they trust that she can do it, she's right for the role, and they'll hire her. Any questions? I can tell you that for me, because when I met you in Newmarket,
yes,
that summer camp, and your mom said she's interested, but she's a little anxious, and I looked at you and you smiled and had all the big things going across your head. I want to be an actor. I thought, okay, well, we can work with this. But over the year and a half, you have worked diligently and consistently building who you are. And I noticed times when you come in, you were tired and so forth.
Yeah.
I kept pushing you. I kept telling you. Now you believe me.
Yeah.
Now you feel it. Now you know it's real. Now let that inspire you, because look, building your dream is building it by design. You're going to see this girl, you out there, going to see this girl go places. This is the beginning. So learn from her experience, learn from what it is she's doing, and take action. Don't just turn off the video and not do anything and now go back to watching SpongeBob. Okay? Take action. All right? I'm so proud of you. I'm in the business of helping people make their dreams come true, helping people live their dreams. But I can't help you if you won't help yourself.
Yeah.
And you're big in helping yourself. So let me ask you this. What is, of all the success qualities you have, what's probably the best success quality that you believe you have?
Being confident and not nervous.
Being confident and not nervous. A great man once said, all I need to teach you is confidence, and everything else will look after itself. She's good. She's really, 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 really good. And you're seeing her for the first time now. Now she's going to move. Okay? I'm very proud of you, Miss Brianna.
Thank you.
Very proud. Thank you for coming down. She just did an acting class with our kids here. Can you give her a big hand, please? So why do you like teaching them again?
Because I think it's really cool to be able to inspire them and show them everything that I've been through and realize the reality of it all, and that if you work towards something, it can come true. So you just have to keep working, and I think it's really cool to let them know that it's real and I've been through it, and it's honestly so fun and I love it so much, and yeah. So there's a stage And then they had all the like makeup people and the mirrors and everything over here. And then here's where all the clothes were and stuff. And that's the producer, Stefan. And so that's me just waiting for her to give me like my clothes to change into. So that was all the wardrobe stuff. And there was like a lot of stuff going on. There's like makeup everywhere, hair products everywhere and everything. This is me getting my makeup done. So here's one of the makeup ladies, Melanie. And then that's the other one, Andrea. And so I'm just waiting for them to put my makeup on and do my hair. But yeah, it was really pretty and it was actually really big. And there was like a huge forest in the back. And I did a lot of outdoor filming scenes. And this is an outdoor filming scene. This is the first scene that we filmed, but it isn't the first scene in the show because they never film everything in order. It's always out of order at different times. So here's all, you can see the lights and there's one of the cameras and you can see the boom person with the sound. And a lot of the production people, there's the cabin in the back and we had to get out of the car for the first scene. So that's the car and everything. And it was just really fun. And then that's it. So in the end, when I did the rehearsal, they borrowed some of my clothes to do. So in the end, they said since they let me use their clothes, I could have some of their clothes. So I took this jacket and a pair of pants. So in the episode, I'm actually wearing this jacket quite a few times. And yeah, it's really cool because it's really pretty and I got to keep it. And it was a really fun experience and you should really just keep going at it because it was honestly amazing. And I don't know, I just love it.
Give her a big hand, please. Now, this is Sharon, and Sharon is Brianna's mom. And I just brought her here for a moment because backstage we were talking, when Brianna was doing her stuff, we were talking about the film and why the producers and directors were so impressed with her. So I just wanted you to tell the kids at home, like, what was going on? Why did they like her so much?
Well, the comments the producer and director made to my husband and I was that she seemed very professional, very natural on camera. They kept asking over and over again every day, are you sure she hasn't done this before? Are you sure this is her first job? And they were all very impressed. The crew as well had made several comments, the sound guys and the wardrobe people. You know, she's done really well. And at the end of the day, they always would thank us and say, you know, we're looking forward to tomorrow's scenes because she's natural at this. And they were really impressed that they have a minute, second by second, time is money for them. So that every scene is a certain number of minutes and that is all they have for that scene and they got to move on to the next one and you better get it right for them to move on because they only have so many days for production and they're moving on to the next phase of production for another show. So you know, you're there till 9:30 one night, you're there till 10:30 another night, you're there till midnight another night and it says it right on the call sheet and they finish on time every day. And time is money. If they don't, they have to pay these people overtime and the crew, and they do not want to stay. So they kept saying over and over again, we're finishing early every day. Your daughter's amazing. She's done, you know, she doesn't have to repeat it. She takes direction really well. We can't believe it's her first time doing this. Normally at this age, especially the first job, they're very aware of the cameras and there's a lot of looking at the camera and they have to cut and stop and redo. Mm-hmm. And they never had to do that, not once with her. So they were really impressed that they did the 5 or 6 or 7 or 8 shots, whatever they had decided they were going to do. Sometimes they do the same shot from a different angle. And it wasn't that they got it wrong, it's just a different angle for to put the editing together at the end. But they finished on time every single time and early on some days. So they were really impressed by that. They said that's really unusual, even with experienced actors. So they were quite impressed. They kept asking how she's so prepared and are you sure this is her first job? And I just basically told them she'd been doing lessons for quite some time and was really working on it before we even took her to any audition so that she kind of got a feel for it. And when she went in front of the cameras, it wasn't nerve-wracking to her. It was natural for her. And they said, well, you can really tell that she's done the work and we really appreciate it and they loved her for that reason.
That is amazing. Yeah, when you save them money, they love you, okay? Anybody that's ever done you guys will be doing it soon in the next class. No more tangled shampoo and bubble bath, okay? You learn the value of getting it right. So we've already been there. Your professionalism, her professionalism is wonderful. And her dedication is what makes all that really, really good. And I'm very proud to have been a part of that. But you as a mom, supporting, here's the thing, you guys want to be an actor. Without mom or dad's support, it makes it a lot harder. So you really gotta see if you can get mom and dad support, and don't take them for granted. You need to seriously give them a hug, because your success is all about them being and loving and supporting you. And your success, your dedication with your daughter over this almost 2 years has been just so commendable as a mother giving up her time. And I'm a dad, I got two kids. I know what it's like. Taking them to martial arts, taking them to this, taking them, I get it. But thank you so much for being a part of, obviously, of your daughter living her dreams.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, and this is her thing, this is what she wants to do, so why not be supportive of that, right?
So. Absolutely. So now you've got some really good tips to work with. You've listened to Brianna. You've learned some really good strategies. You go to my site there. You can read up on Celebrity Online. You can read her action plan, Brianna's action plan, about where she's going and how she's doing this. And listening now to Sharon, and take what she's saying to heart. Listen to it, because it's about being professional, being on set, being on time, and being ready to deliver. I hope all of this has served you. And hopefully I'll see you again next time. Thank you for now. Bye.